looking at why Helene was so bad in this area. It really leads to flash flooding in mountainous terrain, and there really wasn't as much water that fell on the Tennessee side, you know, 5 to 7 inches or so of rain on our side, but 15, 20, 25 plus inches at the headwaters of the Pigeon, the Nolichucky, and the French Broad. And certainly in our area, the Nolichucky, being in the Nolichucky watershed, all of that rainwater that fell so quickly over the course of about 48 hours had to go somewhere. And it starts in a broad area at the headwaters, lots of streams and tributaries, and then it all channels down eventually to the Nolichucky in that case. And all of the debris that comes with it, just all funneling through there, narrow gorge there in Unicoi, coming into Unicoi County from the North Carolina side. It happened so quick, like the flow rate was really astounding, just more than double what we had really recorded in the past. Stage heights well above record heights, just nothing that we had seen before. So all that debris, all of that flow, so quick, just really overwhelmed a lot of the infrastructure and surprised people. You know, they were in areas that were not within what's traditionally considered the floodable area, the 100-year floodplain, and really this was more similar to a 1,000-year event or 1 in 1,000 event. And so the extent of flooding extended well beyond areas that people expected to see flooding. And so that was a surprise, and how quickly the water got there and the debris. One of the stories we heard, you know, was the house that started floating away, and then some of the debris hit the house and that imploded the house. And so those types of things happened so quickly that it was really hard for some people to get to a safe location.